In this segment, we're going to talk about true errors. And if you look at the definition of true error is defined as follows. It is denoted by uppercase E subscript T, uppercase E standing for error and T standing for true. It is defined as the exact value minus the approximate value. So the question arises that why do we need to learn about true errors when we do need the exact value for calculating the true error? So because we are going to be using approximate, the numerical methods are approximate methods. So if I'm going to use numerical methods to find an approximate value of some quantity, I will not have the privilege of knowing what the exact value is. And if I had the privilege of knowing what the exact value is, then I wouldn't be calculating the approximate value in the first place. But the reason why you want to learn about true errors and do need to know the concept of true errors is because if you are developing a numerical method to be able to calculate this approximate value, you do need to test it out against something which you know. So for example, if you have developed an approximate way of differentiating a function, you would like to compare it with something which you have learned in your differential calculus class with some exact value. And we'll take an example of that to be able to explain it. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's go ahead and take an example and see what we mean by calculating the true errors. So for example, somebody says that, hey, I want you to use this formula for calculating the derivative of a function. Now, if you remember your differential calculus class, this approximate formula for calculating the derivative of the function is very similar to what you learned in your differential calculus class. The only difference was that your f prime of x was defined exactly equal to by taking delta x approaching 0. So this is the definition from your differential calculus class. If you want to calculate the derivative of a function, you'll have to choose delta x to be approaching 0. But if I'm going to, I cannot choose delta x approaching 0 in a numerical method because every time I choose a delta x, I'll have to choose one smaller than that because that will only mean the delta x approaching 0. So as an approximation, what you do is rather than choosing delta x approaching 0, you choose delta x to be a finite number. So what we're going to do is we're going to compare the values which we'll get from this approximate way of finding a derivative of a function and the exact way of finding the derivative of a function. So because we need both the numbers to be able to calculate whatever true error is. So let's go and put some functions and numbers which we are interested in. So let's suppose somebody says, hey, the function is given to you as 7 e to the power 0.5x. And you're also given that, hey, you want to calculate f prime of 2. And you're going to choose a delta x equal to 0.3, let's suppose. So you're given the function, you're given where you want to calculate the derivative of the function, that's what you have to find, and you're given that you're choosing a finite value of delta x, in this case being 0.3. So let's go ahead and see that what we get from, because we need two things, we need exact value and we need the approximate value, so let's calculate the exact value first. So the exact value, we have f of x equal to 7 e to the power 0.5x. F prime of x from my differential equation, differential calculus class is 7 times 0.5 e to the power 0.5x. So that gives me 3.5 e to the power 0.5x. The formula which I use to calculate the derivative of the function is from my differential calculus class where it says d by dx of e to the power ax is defined as a e to the power ax, where a is a constant. So that's where we get that from. So from here, I can calculate my f prime of 2 to be 3.5 e to the power 0.5 times 2. And that value turns out to be 9.5140. And that's the exact value. Now, you would get the same number if you would have used the definition, the exact definition of the derivative. which is a little lengthy, so I'm not showing you that. I'm just showing you directly the application of the formula which you learned in your differential calculus class. So let's go and now calculate our approximate value based on the formula which we just was given to us. What is the approximate value? So I'll show it here. Approximate value again was defined as that f prime of x is approximately equal to the numerator being this and the denominator being delta x, just like in the exact definition of your derivative function. The only difference being that delta x is now a finite number as opposed to being being approaching zero. So we again want to calculate f prime at 2. So that gives us f at 2 plus delta x minus f at 2 divided by delta x. Now also we're given that delta x is 0.3, so I'm going to substitute that. So I'm showing you separate steps here so that you understand what each step means. So that is the approximate derivative of the function at 2.3, which is basically obtained from finding the value of the function at 2.3, finding the value of the function at 2, and dividing it by 0.3. So what is the value of the function at 0.3? Is 7 e to the power 0.5 times 2.3 minus 7 e to the power 0.5 times the value of x, which is 2, divided by 0.3. And this number here turns out to be equal to 10.265. So that's the approximate value of the derivative of the function we're getting at the value of x equal to 2. In order to be able to calculate what is the true error associated with this approximate value, we do need to know the exact value, which we just calculated a few minutes ago. So let's go and take those two numbers and see what the true error is. So the true error, again, is defined as true value minus approximate value. And the true value which we calculated was 9.5140. And the approximate value which we calculated was 10.265. And this gives me a true error of minus 0.75061. So that's how you're going to calculate your true errors, based on simply calculating the true value or the exact value and subtracting from that the approximate value. And that's the end of this segment.